got another video for ya. Check me out. Okay, so right now, I'm gonna talk to y'all about a video I like to call The War for Your Mind, right? Right now, we are in a war for your mind. For your mind as an adult, for your mind as a child, especially children. They got a stadium right now, 24,000 kids in Australia that's getting vaccinated and no parents allowed on the premises. That's enough right there. That's enough to be said right there. I shouldn't even have to go no further than that. They don't want parents there because they want to be able to get over on the child. Regardless of the fact that you're not in there as a parent, it's still other adults in there who administering the test that the child is going to listen to just off the strength that the fact that that's an adult. Now, if a parent was in there and him as an adult say something wrong to your child or try to do something wrong to your child, you're going to be able to check that. And they don't want that. They want to have the controls. Why would I let my child go to a whole stadium with 23,000 other children to go get a vaccination? Well, and I can't be there. Why would I do that? Just because of the fact that the stipulation is the parent can't be there. My child won't go. Just off the strength of that. I'm saying, you just want to have total control over my child's mind when I'm not around. Video games, right? The video games that they make today is made to consume your child's mind. Okay, let's take something as simple as the video game 2K, right? 2K21, 22, 19, 17, it don't matter. Pick one. In order to achieve greatness on this game, to be at the top tier, you have to spend a long time on the game. You understand what I'm saying? No breaks. They got it to where you can't do nothing else, basically. All that time he's spending on the game trying to achieve legend status, he not reading no books. He not working on building nothing. He not doing nothing that's gonna build his future because he's trying to be a legend on 2K21. They make the game like that on purpose. It's all a war for your mind. That's why when you tell the child to get up, go clean his room, he get upset. He get to throwing the joystick down, breaking shit. Cause you tell him to go do something that he's supposed to already be doing, which is clean his room. Whatever you have him to go do, soon as he gotta get unplugged from the game, he is upset. Cause the game got his mind. It's a war for your mind, bro. Let me tell you something about the adults. When you look at shit like Love and Hip Hop and all that old shit right there, Love and Hip Hop is the worst thing that ever came out for black women in America. Any of them shows that's like that, from Love and Hip Hop, Flavor Love, all that shit, that's the worst thing that they ever made for TV for black women, bro. Even before that, but that helped perpetuate a war for your mind. You got women going out here right now getting their bodies done. They are going away from what God gave them. You know what I'm saying? They are not happy with what God gave them, how God built them. They're not happy with that. And they're not happy with that because in their mind, this is what beauty look like. This is how you have to look in order to get a rich nigga. This is how you have to look in order to get some attention. This is what these type of shows show you, my nigga. These are what these type of shows tell you. It's a war for your mind. They have your mind. You get to looking at that shit. The women on Instagram, they look just like the women on Love and Hip Hop. Most of the women on Instagram that's on the Explore page and shit like that, they look like the women on Love and Hip Hop. So you feel like in order for you to compete, you got to do the same thing. It's a competition. They make you think that's what life is about, bro. God made you perfect, my nigga. You ain't got to do nothing to change it. When you change it, you saying you going against what God built. You not satisfied with what God gave you. It's a war for your mind. Now, women right now on Instagram think that's what they got to look like to get a man or to get the man they want. Not knowing them hoes get cheated on too. Half them hoes on Instagram, bro, next to homeless, bro. They living with their fat homegirl and all that shit, man. A lot of y'all females that's going to work every day, y'all in 10 times better shape than them hoes, bro, financially. Stop idolizing them hoes, my nigga. Them hoes ain't got half of what you got, my nigga. If a nigga stop sponsoring them, they ain't gonna go get a job, they gonna try to find the next lame nigga. That's what they gonna try to go do, my nigga. You getting up going to work every day. You think this hoe something. This hoe ain't nothing. You stop doing that shit. It's a war for your mind, bro. They got your mind. War for your mind, bro. Them hoes ain't about nothing. Mostly all them Instagram model hoes, none of them hoes really got knowledge of self. That's why they on there twerking and shit like that. You don't see Tamika Mallory doing that shit on her page. You do not see people like Tamika Mallory dressing like them Instagram models that's on the Explore page. You're not gonna see that shit. They captions ain't the same. They content, the shit they post is not the same. Them are two different wings. And Kay Watson, I can't really pronounce her name. She not gonna post the type of shit that most of these women is posting on Instagram. She not gonna post that type of shit. She have her own fucking mind. Tamika Mallory have her own mind. She have her own mind, and she have more to offer than just beauty. That's why these niggas don't, that's why ass ain't just enough, man. Nigga get a bad bitch and still run this hoe through the dirt. You know what? Cause it's some more ass around the corner. It's not good enough, bro. It's always gonna be a better bitch. That shit ain't enough, my nigga. You better have your own mind, bro. If they take your kid's mind, then they mind ain't on learning where they come from. They mind ain't on learning knowledge of self, cause they on a video all game trying to be a fucking legend. So they don't have no knowledge of self. They don't know nothing else. And when they get older, you're gonna see that they not gonna be prepared for the real world because they mind been gone. They mind, they been gave their mind away to something else. The ones who use their mind to build shit is gonna be in a better position in life, just like right now. When you was a kid and you was running around, running to the club and running around doing shit, and you see other motherfuckers was going to school, learning shit like that, and you see how they living right now, you see how you living. They in a whole nother state. They living a whole different life. They flying around the world. They living their best life, my nigga. They got a foundation set. You was running around having fun. You was having fun, my nigga. Your mind was gone already. You understand what I'm saying? It is a war for your mind, bro. You are what you eat. You are what you listen to. If you don't exercise, your mind is going to get lazy. And it's guerrilla warfare out here, man. Niggas be saying they real gorillas, man, but this shit is real. If you a real gorilla, you know, not, don't be a real gorilla on your people, my nigga. You want to be a real gorilla against your people. Be a real gorilla against your oppressor, bro. That's when I'ma be impressed. Anybody can kill another nigga. That's not gangster. That's not impressive. Stand up for the culture. It's a whole war going on for your mind by the oppressor, and you talking about you a gorilla when you ain't doing nothing to fix it. You talking about you a gorilla because you could kill another nigga. Come on, man. What about the people that's trying to take steal your child's mind? Be a gorilla on them. I don't understand you niggas, bro, and y'all claim to be real niggas. I don't get that, bro. Newsflash. If you're not trying to push the culture forward, if you're not trying to teach these kids, if you're not trying to get them out the street and show them that this shit that we grew up on ain't about nothing, you are not a real nigga. I don't give a fuck how many bitches you fuck, how much money you got. You are not a real nigga. Fuck out of here, man.